Subscribe to LearnCab and hit the bell icon to get notified.
Cost of capital. The next important segment, cost of capital. With respect to cost of capital, two things are there here. One is cost, another one is capital. Capital, you know, either by way of own fund or by way of borrowed fund. In that manner only, you are going to procure the fund, capital. Cost of the capital. Own fund, what are the cost?
Dividend.
What is the doubt? Own fund, what is the cost of the company? Dividend. Borrowed fund means?
Interest.
That's why I told you, everything you have to see in what? Company's point of view. Interest. Okay, company's point of view, you have to see. You know, characteristics of source of fund. What are all the characters are there? Risk, cost and control. High risk goes to? High cost goes to? High control goes to? Comfortable or not? Therefore, in case of own fund, what are the cost of the company? In case of borrowed fund, what are the cost of the company?
Yes.
Therefore, here we are going to discuss about payment of dividend and the payment of interest. Are you with me or not? In between, after paying interest, before paying dividend, company has to pay tax. Am I right or not? Tax, after paying interest only you have to pay tax. But before paying dividend. Are you with me or not? Therefore, how we are going to make use of the tax portion? The tax benefit will be there in dividend fund for payment of dividend or payment of tax? Payment of interest. For payment of interest, you are having tax benefit. Clear? We are discussed at the time of source of fund itself. Am I right? At the time of what? Basic concept itself. Therefore, here we are going to discuss about cost of dividend, cost of interest. Interest is the cost, dividend is the cost. Therefore, cost of own fund, cost of borrowed fund. You know, interest they will express in terms of what?
Percentage.
Therefore, cost of capital, we have to express in terms of percentage. What is the percentage? I am going to borrow the loan. 10%, 12%, 14%. We are expressing in terms of percentage, you know. They won't tell 1 lakh, 2 lakhs, 5 lakhs. Am I right? Therefore, cost of capital, we have to express in terms of percentage. What is the overview of cost of capital? All of you. Now, with respect to cost of capital, I'll tell the three scenarios. If you are comfortable with respect to three scenarios, cost of capital, very, very easy. That's the basic concept with respect to cost of capital. Just like that, you should not mug in the formula. You have to understand the concept. Clear? So, the concept you are going to learn by way of the three scenario. Such a simplest scenario only. Now, scenario one. Procurement of fund. 100 lakhs. For that, I have to pay interest because nobody is going to give the fund at free of cost. I paid interest 10 lakhs. Procurement of fund, how many lakhs?
100 lakhs.
How much I am paying interest?
10 lakhs.
Therefore, cost of capital comes to how much?
10 lakhs.
10 lakhs mean I'll kill you. Cost of capital comes to how much?
10%.
What is this? You have to be focused here. Cost of capital, how much? 10%. Easy or difficult? How you have to compute 10%? 10 lakhs divided by 100 lakhs into 100. 10 lakhs represent what? Interest. 100 lakhs represent what? Therefore, 100 lakhs is inflow of cash or outflow of cash? Our inflow of cash. 10 lakhs is a? Therefore, outflow divided by inflow into 100 is equal to our cost. Am I right or not? The same thing we have discussed at the time of? The same thing we have discussed at the time of factoring, cost of factoring. I told you or not? Numerator, what are the cost of factoring formula? Numerator. Factoring we finished or not? How to compute? Numerator. Denominator. Advance amount. That is the inflow. Advance amount of factoring. Numerator. Net cost of factoring. Numerator outflow, denominator inflow. You forget or what? You wrote the test also then. What is this? Now, any doubt with respect to cost of capital? First scenario, very easy. Am I right? Hello? Now, shall I go for second scenario number two? Scenario two. Procurement of fund 100 lakhs. Payment of interest 10 lakhs. And expenses for the procurement. Okay? Assume 2 lakhs. Prospectus or issuing commission. Like that, some expense will be there, no? That comes to 2 lakhs. Therefore, cost of capital comes to how much? How much is the cost of capital? Are you able to follow or not? What percentage? 12%. Comfortable or not? Why? How much is the outflow? How much is the inflow? Therefore, outflow 12, inflow 100 into 100 is equal to what? 12%. Okay? But. Interest 10 lakhs. Okay? It's a recurring expenses or non-recurring expenses? Till I am going to settle the money, I have to incur. Therefore, recurring. But 2 lakhs expenses on procurement, recurring or non-recurring? One time. Is it possible for to merge the both? Not possible. Are you with me or not? Therefore, numerator outflow, denominator inflow. Numerator 10 lakhs my outflow. Every year I have to pay 10 lakhs. Denominator, I am 100 lakhs I am getting, but 2 lakhs expenses gone. Therefore, net inflow to the company how much?
98.
Therefore, for the purpose of 98 lakhs, every year I have to pay interest of 10 lakhs. Are you with me or not? Therefore, what are the rate, Kana? 10.20%. How many have understood scenario 2? Got it? Now, shall I go to the next one? Good. Scenario 3 is the most important one. If you understood third scenario, cost of capital oversell. I am ready. Are you ready?
Yes.
Now, listen here. Procurement of fund 100 lakhs. Expenses incurred comes to 2 lakhs. Interest comes to 10 lakhs. And tax rate comes to 30%. What are the cost of capital? What are the cost of capital? Try. What could be the cost of capital? Try. Don't wait for my answer. Try. That's the reason it should be strong in the basic concept. Now, listen here. Denominator, 98. Why 98? 100 lakhs I am procuring, 2 lakhs expenses gone, therefore remaining 98 lakhs into 100. Numerator, 10 lakh is my cash outflow because I have to pay interest. If I am going to pay interest 10 lakhs, I can debit in my P&L account. If I am going to debit the same in P&L account, profit will come down to the extent of 10 lakhs. Profit is coming down to the extent of 10 lakhs, tax 30% come down. Am I right? 30% on 10 lakh comes to 3 lakhs. Therefore, I am paying 10 lakhs, that's the expenses, whereas another hand I am saving 3 lakhs because of the tax. Therefore, my net cash flow comes to 110 lakhs minus, what minus what? 100 minus or 1 minus tax rate. Am I right? Therefore, how much gone? Balance 70% only I am going to pay net. Am I right? So, 10 lakhs into 70% is equal to numerator what? 7 lakhs. Are you with me or not? Nothing but 10 lakh I am paying, 3 lakh I am saving. Therefore, net comes to 7 lakhs. Are you with me? Therefore, 7 divided by 98 into 100 is equal to 7.14%. How many of you understood the third scenario? Third one is the most important one. It's purely based on the basic concept. Are you comfortable? Based on that only, we are going to solve the problem. Based on third scenario only, we are going to solve the problem. All are comfortable? Now, with respect to cost of capital, what and all we have to what? Going to discuss. First one, cost of debt fund. Loan fund, debt fund, debenture fund, debt fund. Okay? Loans and debenture. Cost of preference shares fund. Cost of equity fund. And overall cost. So first we are going to discuss about what? Debt fund alone separately, what are the costs? Like what? Interest on loan. Similarly, preference share if I am going to procure, what are the cost of the company? Equity share mean, what are the cost of the company? And company as a whole, total procurement, not only debt alone or equity alone, combination of debt and equity, total procurement how much? Total cost how much? Average basis, how much the total cost of the company? If I am going to get more than one loan, then total cash flow you have to see, no? Arithmia or not? Therefore, overall cost of the cost of mine, you have to compute. Same manner, company as a whole, more than one source will be there. Debt, equity, okay? Debt also what? Debenture also will be there, okay? Loans also will be there. Combination of all total procurement, how much? Further, how much you have to pay? That is called overall cost. Therefore, four segments we are going to come across now. What are the first one? Cost of debt fund, cost of preference shares, cost of equity, and overall more than one procurement is there mean, then how to compute the overall cost. This is what the four segment we are going to discuss in our forum. All are comfortable? Got overview with respect to cost of capital? Kindly note it down. Cost of debt. Note it down. Cost of debt. It represents. It represents cost incurred for the purpose of procurement of fund. Cost incurred for the purpose of procurement of fund by way of cost incurred for the purpose of procurement of fund by way of debentures and loan. Debentures and loan. Cost incurred for the purpose of procurement of fund by way of debentures and loan. Here cost represent payment of what? Interest. Cost represent payment of interest. Cost of debt is denoted by way of. Cost of debt is denoted by way of KD. Okay, Sundariya. Cost of debt is denoted by way of KD. See, your name and all coming in the subject itself. Now, computation bifurcated into two parts. Computation bifurcated into two parts. Irredeemable debt and redeemable debt. Irredeemable debt, another one is redeemable debt. Under irredeemable debt, KD is equal to, don't write your name, okay? KD is equal to interest into 100 minus tax rate or 1 minus tax rate, okay? Interest into 100 minus tax rate divided by NP. Divided by NP. In case of redeemable, formula KD is equal to interest into 100 minus tax rate plus RV minus NP divided by N whole divided by RV plus NP divided by 2. RV minus NP divided by N whole divided by RV plus NP, RV plus NP divided by 2. Okay? Underneath, where NP represent net profits of issue, నెట్ ప్రాసిట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇష్యూ, బై వే ఆఫ్ ఇష్యూ హౌ మచ్ యూఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు గెట్ నెట్ ఇన్ఫ్లో. ఆర్ వి రిప్రజెంట్ రిడెంప్షన్ వాల్యూ, ఆర్ వి రిప్రజెంట్ రిడెంప్షన్ వాల్యూ. ఎన్ రిప్రజెంట్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఇయర్స్, ఎన్ రిప్రజెంట్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఇయర్స్. నోట్ కేడి వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ పర్సంటేజ్. ఓకే, వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ పర్సంటేజ్. నౌ వాట్ పాయింట్స్ టు బి రిమెంబర్, వాట్ ద ఫార్ములా ఫార్ ఇర్రెడ్యూబుల్ డెట్ కేడి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు రెస్పాండ్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ ఇంటూ డివైడెడ్ బై, ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ రెడీమబుల్ కేడి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఇన్ ఎగ్జామ్ ఇన్ క్వశ్చన్ దే ఆస్ ఫైండ్ కాస్ట్ ఆఫ్ డెట్, దే ఆస్ ఓన్లీ లైక్ దట్స్, దే వోంట్ స్పెసిఫై ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఈస్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ రెడీమబుల్ ఆర్ ఇర్రెడీమబుల్. You have to identify. Accordingly, formula also going to vary. Are you with me or not? How to identify, sir? If year of redemption is given, 5th year they are going to redeem, 10th year they are going to redeem. Year of redemption given in this question means we have to solve the problem by way of redeemable. Else, year of redemption is not given, open-ended. Then we have to assume, we have to solve the problem by way of irredeemable. Accordingly, you have to solve the problem. Are with me or not? Only in case year of redemption given in this question means we have to solve it by way of redeemable. If year of redemption is not given, then we have to solve it by way of irredeemable.
Subscribe to LearnCab and hit the bell icon to get notified.